Welcome back to Crash Course in Entomology. Today we'll be learning about the four insect orders that exhibit the most diversity, known as the Big Four Insect Orders. As discussed in the previous episode, the evolution of holometabolous development allowed for the insects with it to operate in different niches depending on their life cycle stage, with larvae specialized to feed and grow, and adults specialized to mate. These insects maximized their productivity. This developmental specialization led to the orders Hymenoptera, Coleoptera, Lepidoptera, and Diptera to be immensely successful. The order Hymenoptera contains a variety of different types of organisms, each with a different set of unique evolutionary innovations. Hymenopterans can be identified by their four membranous wings, with their forewings and hindwings hooked together, their biting chewing mouthparts, lapping proboscis, and conspicuous ovipositor. Hymenopterans are haplodiploid insects, with different species exhibiting innovations such as sociality, parasitism, and stingers. About that word I mentioned a second ago, haplodiploid. Haplodiploidy is a genetic adaptation in which an unfertilized egg will develop into a male, and a fertilized egg will develop into a female. This adaptation may not seem like much, but its importance will become more apparent when we cover the evolution of sociality in insects. Hymenopterans can be divided into four main groups: wasps, bees, ants, and sawflies. Wasps can be differentiated from other hymenopterans by their constricted waist, smooth bodies, or at least much less hairy than bees, and long hind legs. Wasp larvae are highly reduced and maggot-like. The reduction of larvae's features increases the more social a wasp species is. Wasps are mostly solitary organisms, however there do exist some social species. Wasps operate in many different niches, with different species acting as pollinators, parasites, parasitoids, predators, prey, and even pests. Bees are the most economically important insects in the world, and they can be identified by their hairy bodies, broad hindlegs for holding pollen, and well-developed eyes. The larvae of bees lack many features, just like wasp larvae, and just like wasps, bees are mostly solitary organisms. However, there do exist some incredibly notable social species. Social bees have a highly developed social structure and movement-based communication systems. Ants are hymenopterans adapted exclusively for eusociality, with all ant species being eusocial. Ants can be identified by their constricted abdomen, elbowed antennae, and prominent mandibles. Ant larvae are incredibly physically reduced and are cared for by older ants. Like social bees, ants have a highly developed social structure and pheromone-based communication systems. The previous three hymenopteran groups are all very well known. However, there is another not as popular faction of this order, the sawflies. Unlike most other hymenopterans, sawflies have a broad waist rather than the usually constricted abdomen. These organisms can be identified by this broad waist as adults, but most unique traits of this group appear in their larval stage. Unlike the highly structurally reduced larvae of ants, bees, and wasps, sawfly larvae are highly complex and caterpillar-like. The key difference between sawfly larvae and caterpillars is that sawfly larvae have more prolegs. Insects in the order Coleoptera, the beetles, can be identified by their elytra, which are hardened forewings modified to protect the beetle, and their chewing, biting mouthparts. Other than these two features, beetles are incredibly diverse with plenty of modifications. In fact, Coleoptera is the most diverse order of any living thing, with over 350,000 species described. To put this into perspective, if you were to pick a species of animal out of all animals at random from a hat, there's a roughly 25% chance it'll be a beetle. The larvae of beetles are called grubs and have chewing, biting mouthparts. Beetles have a myriad of useful adaptations. To list a few, these include swimming legs as seen in diving and water beetles, parasitism as seen in flatbark beetles, star position navigation used by dung beetles, acid spraying used by bombarder beetles, horns used by rhinoceros and Hercules beetles, and bioluminescence seen in fireflies and glowworms. Lepidoptera is the order containing butterflies, moths, and skippers. The name Lepidoptera describes the main identifying features of the group, meaning scale wing. Another key feature of Lepidopterans is their coiled proboscis that adults use for feeding. Lepidopterans are known for their feeding behaviors like nectar drinking and mud puddling. Their larvae are called caterpillars and have five pairs of prolegs. Like bees, these organisms co-evolved with flowering plants. Lepidopterans can be divided into three groups: butterflies, moths, and skippers. Butterflies can be identified by their thin bodies, clubbed antennae, and disconnected wing pairs. Butterflies develop in a hard chrysalis and rest with wings closed and upright. This group is usually diurnal and are almost always colorful. The caterpillars of butterflies are usually sleek and smooth, but many have external projection slash coloration that help them keep predators at bay through colorful warnings and cryptic camouflage. Moths can be identified by their thicker bodies, short feathery antennae, and wing pairs that are attached to one another, similar to the wing hooks of hymenopterans. Moths develop in a silky pupa and rest with their wings open along their body. Moths are usually nocturnal and dull in color. The caterpillars of moth are generally fuzzy with chemical defenses. The lesser-known group of lepidopterans, the skippers, have traits in common with both butterflies and moths. Skippers have thick bodies like moths and clubbed antennae like butterflies. The antennae of skippers also have pointed, hooked tips. Caterpillars are the larvae of Lepidoptera, and they possess a variety of tools that make them an exceptional larval stage. Most caterpillars are herbivorous, but predatory species do exist. They have five pairs of prolegs and can possess chemical defenses. The chemical defenses of caterpillars include poisons retained from food, irritating hairs, and venomous spines. An interesting behavior possessed by Lepidopterans is mud puddling, in which they gather around mud puddles to drink mineral-laden water. Lepidopterans do this as they require salts in their diet that the nectar of flowers does not contain. The need for salt in Lepidopteran diets has led to interesting developments in certain species. For example, male vampire moths get their vital salts from drinking blood. The order Diptera contains the organisms known as true flies. True flies can be identified by their halteres, which are sensory structures formed from what used to be their hindwings, their single pair of functional wings, their large, well-developed compound eyes, and their variable mouthparts. The mouthparts a fly has is indicative of what they feed on, with certain species exhibiting piercing sucking, sponging, or absent mouthparts. True flies are highly diverse, with roles as pollinators and pests. Their larvae are called maggots and are highly reduced, except for their mouth hooks. True flies are a highly diverse group, and they fill out a wide variety of niches. Flies play a role in decomposition, pollination, biocontrol, forensics, and medicine. In addition to the benefits true flies provide humanity, some can also be harmful, with roles of disease vectors and house and agricultural pests. Fly larvae are known as maggots and can live in almost any environment, but are more commonly adapted to moist environments. These organisms feed on almost anything and perfectly fill out the role of generalists. Well, everybody, that about wraps up this video on the big four insect orders. Please subscribe for more lessons in entomology and leave a like if you learned something new. Until next time, this has been Crash Course in Entomology.